Hello, I am Madani Ariam. In this presentation, I'm going to talk about the people who want to start the business, but they have to think about the money. They have to show yourself the money. You cannot start a business without capital. Determine what you have, what you will need, and how you will go about getting it. If you plan to seek investor funding or financing, start writing a business plan and practice your pitch. Research the cost associated with a business. Know how much money you will need and decide where it could come from. Do you have enough capital? Many businesses out there fail because of the lack of capital. Show yourself the money. You cannot start a business without capital. Determine what you have, what you will need, and how you will go about getting it. If you plan to seek investor funding or financing, start writing business plan and practice your pitch. Research the cost along with your business, that goes along with your business. Know how much money you will need and decide where it could come from. So prepare your budget before even you start up your store. And estimate the profit and loss statement. And prepare the estimated profit and loss statement as well. Have some consultations with accounting companies if you want to be successful. Why do the small business need a business bank account? I will explain a couple of reasons for it. When your business transactions arise, you need to have a recording system to be aware of your business activities. If you have a separate bank accounts, it will be easy for you to prepare the recordings. That will give you a peace of mind. In case the tax inspector comes in, if you produce a bank statement, it will impress them, and also it will be easy for them to check your business transactions. A designated account will be useful for you to have an overdraft facility as well. A bank account is crucial because if you don't have a separate bank account, you might start to mix up with the personal transactions, and that will end up in a big mess, and therefore you will have lots of problems with preparing the financial statements. You might overstate the profit or you might understate the profit. That all leads to lots of problems like that. On the other hand, you need to learn to read the bank statements and be able to reconcile with your transactions. And if you have too many operations, you need to have a bookkeeper. If you become confident with internet marketing, you can save a lot of time. You can check your bank statement on a daily basis. How to use a cash book and how will you use to enter your transactions? You have to start with a cash book when you are starting with a small business. It's important because you've got to enter the daily transactions. The payments will be debited, and also it's a double entry bookkeeping, and the credit will be the revenue. Unfortunately, the cash book will not show the cash transactions. That will have to be recorded separately. The cash book is for the double entry bookkeeping, and single entry, that is the cash transactions, will have to be recorded separately. You need to record that as well, otherwise you will have problems when you are crafting the financial statements. Two possible ways of updating the cash book. One is then and there you start writing the daily transactions as the business go along, or wait for the bank statements and enter all the transactions, then do the bank reconciliation. Cash transactions refer to payments or receipts of cash. Cash received from sale of assets, loans, investments, borrowing, and capital received. Cash payments are for purchases, rent, rates, salaries, credits, creditors and loan repayments, directors' drawings, interest on loans or liabilities. Banking nowadays deals with the most of their transactions through their bank accounts. Business nowadays, sorry. It is a safety measure to stop using cash directly for the purchase and sales or any other operations, because you will be doing a lot of purchases and sales. So if you keep using the cash, you will end up in big trouble as well. So better to use the bank for transactions. A business can also instruct the bank to make payments and collect receipts on behalf of the company. There is no cash held in the office. Another term, the petty cash. In this day and age, the businesses, you don't need to have cash in the business. You can have a small amount of cash that's called the petty cash for the use of emergency expenses. These are the things you have to think about before. These are the fundamental things before starting a business. That's very important. I hope you understood this presentation and you like these tips. Thank you. I will make this into video. Then you can watch the video as well. Thank you in advance. Thank you. Bye for now. I'll see you in another one.